This circuit board is of a higher mini split air conditioner of a heat and cool model. This circuit board is not working at all. I will pass the electricity through it and show you all what the issue is with it. Let me tell you how to do the electric connections on this circuit board. Its electric supply moves from the indoor to the outdoor unit. This is the switching relay installed in the circuit board. On this connector, 00N21 is written. I am connecting the line wire with it, and a fuse is attached further. The neutral connection is this on its terminal, 2N is written with it. I will attach the neutral wire to it. Now, I will put the electric plug in the electric socket. It is not getting powered on. I will try to turn it on with the remote. I don't have its own remote, but I am using a universal remote to turn it on. See, yes, it turned on once and then turned off again. The beep sound works once and then again stops. So let me explain what could be the problem. This was the connector where I installed the line wire. A fuse is installed after it. Then, MOV is used, and after the MOV, a capacitor. Then, a line filter. And then the rectification circuit. I will check its rectification diodes first. None of the diodes showed zero voltage drop. The easiest way to repair it quicker is that I will check the voltages of this circuit board now. So over here, a capacitor is installed, which is 22 microfarad and 450 volts. I will test it. Other than this, I will check the SMPS circuit of this circuit board. A power resistor is installed to dissipate heat in the circuit and protect the circuit from overheating. The resistor is 3 watts and 3.6 ohms. Let's check it through a multimeter. I will set the multimeter on ohm mode. The value of the resistor is fine. It seems to have no issue. The number of the switching IC installed in this circuit is 1200P60. I will pass electricity through the circuit board. I will check whether the voltages on the capacitor are passing fine or not. I will set the multimeter on DC volts. 320 volts should have passed through this capacitor, but the voltages passing are not stable. I will change this capacitor. I have replaced the capacitor of the circuit board. I have installed a 400 volt and 22 microfarad capacitor. I will check whether the voltages are stable in the circuit now after replacing the capacitor. I have passed electricity through it, and the display has turned on. Let's check the voltages now. The voltages are stable now, which are 310 DC volts. I will now turn it on with the remote. The display shows the room temperature. I will wait for it to pass the output for the outdoor unit. I powered it off, so I will turn it on again. I will wait for the output to pass from the circuit. It passes the output from the relay installed in the circuit board. It will move further towards the current transformer, and then it will pass towards this connector terminal. But I will have to wait for it to pass the output. It has started to show an E14 error code on the display. This error means that the blower motor is not connected to the circuit board. I will connect the blower motor. Now the circuit board was still not stable. I checked it off the camera and replaced the switching IC. So now, let's check the circuit board again. I am trying to do this work as quickly as possible because the customer is seated in our workshop. Here we go, it has started to pass the output. The tester is glowing when I put the tester on the terminal. Let me show you the voltages through the multimeter. The multimeter is showing 230 volts. So it has been fixed. I am tired now, and I run on coffee. So buy it for me on Patreon. Click the link on the screen to visit. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.